In Germany's case, you have a lot of renewable energies, specifically wind energy in the northern part of the country. And you also have more solar power, sort of photovoltaic energy in the southern parts of the country. And you have also a lot of industry located in the southern parts of the country. And because of this decentralized power, which is being created in the north, that energy needs to come to the south. When electrical energy passes through a conductor, such as a cable, some of that energy gets converted to heat energy. So what needs to happen is that the heat generated by these cables needs to be dissipated through the surrounding medium, which in this case is soils. And for soils that are in close proximity to cables, the water content varies a lot depending on the proximity to the cable. So you have a cable buried in sand that is above groundwater level. The soil, the sand that is close to the cable, will be much drier than the sand that is at a further distance to the cable, which is why when we test the sand, we want to test the entire relationship of water content to thermal conductivity to see what is the thermal conductivity of the sand in its saturated state all the way down to its oven dried state. And you need these two thermal conductivity values in order to do your thermal design.